You're watching the Red Zone Sports Show on Fox 5.
Straight ahead in the Red Zone, UNLV beat San Jose State for the first time since 1994, and they did it in all three phases. Head coach Tony Sanchez is in studio to break down the convincing win in the Mountain West opener. Plus, we preview this Saturday's huge home showdown with unbeaten and nationally ranked San Diego State. And we get to know offensive lineman Kyle Saxelid, whose play is helping the offense put up big numbers while impressing NFL scouts, while his eating ability will impress any in-and-out lover.
What is your intent?
To give you 30 minutes of Rebel football knowledge and power.
Let's go get it!
This is the Fox 5 Red Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie. Your home, your way.
Good evening. Welcome inside the Red Zone. Kevin Bolinger alongside UNLV head football coach Tony Sanchez, where the Rebels are now 1-0. They get the Mountain West Conference season off on the right note. A very good, solid game in all phases.
Yeah, you know, really happy for our guys, coaches, and everyone, you know, everyone in the organization. Everyone's working extremely hard, and it was good to go out and get a convincing win, and just proud of the guys for the effort they put in.
We want to get right to the highlights of this one. The Rebels put the pressure on early, and they did not let up.
What is your focus on tonight? One focus, one play at a time, and that's the win. That's to beat the guy in front of you, play for one another, and at the end of the day, have fun. Have fun, all right? Go.
A fired-up Rebels squad hit the field, and the offense sent a message early. UNLV went hurry up and quickly moved the ball down the field. Armani Rogers flips it to Tim Holt, who rolls into San Jose territory after a 26-yard gain. Lexington Thomas rattles off 16 yards to move it to the red zone. And on 3rd and 3 at the 7, the option. Rogers keeps it himself, and he barrels into the end zone for the touchdown. The Rebels go 75 yards in 9 plays in 3 minutes and 37 seconds, and they take a quick 7-0 lead. After the Spartans hit a 34-yard field goal to make it 7-3, the O went right back at it. Devontae Boyd makes a great catch over the middle for a first at the 26. On 3rd and 5 at the 21, Rogers hits Kendall Keys for the first to keep the drive alive. Then Rogers from the 5 rolls right for the run pass option, and he tucks and runs, pushing it into the end zone for another touchdown, and it was 14-3. San Jose kicked another field goal to make it 14-6, but lightning was about to strike at Sam Boyd, as in Lexington Thomas, who gets a huge hole from the Orcas, makes a move, and he's gone 57 yards for the touchdown. The stadium was rocking, and the Rebels were rolling as they were up 21-6, but they weren't done. Next possession, Rogers with the quick hitter to Brandon Presley, who turns the corner, turns on the Jets, and tightropes down the sidelines, 44 yards for the score, 28-6. How about some special teams? Keep your eye on number 4. Yes, that's former starting quarterback Johnny Stanton, bursting through for the block. The senior saying that he just wants to contribute in any way possible.
It's my senior year. I want to be able to do whatever I can to convert, you know, to help the team. And special teams is a great way to be able to help the team.
The block gave UNLV the ball on the 4, and 2 plays later, Thomas pounds it in for his 20th career touchdown as a Rebel. The Scarlet and Gray were up 35-6. They led at the half 35-13. The defense set the tone at the start of the second half. San Jose quarterback Josh Love picked off by Chauncey Sism. On the next defensive series, the Spartans had a 4th and 2 at the UNLV 19, and Tyler Nevins is swarmed, stuffed, and denied as the Rebels took over at their own 20. They put together a solid 80-yard drive, 3rd and 7 at their own 23. Rogers flushed out of the pocket, and he's gonna have to hoof it. The run moving the chains. Then the delayed handoff to Thomas, who bobs and weaves his way for 12 yards. On 3rd and goal at the 2, play action. Rogers hits Trevor Kahneman for the touchdown. But the defense wasn't done. Watch Jericho Flowers close ground and get the pick in the end zone. And then on the goal line, the defense forcing a fumble and recovering it to thwart another San Jose drive. Two interceptions and a fumble on defense, a blocked punt on special teams, and 548 yards of total offense, including 345 on the ground. It all adds up to a convincing 41-13 win, which led to the first corner field fight song of the season at Sanborn.
Especially going into conference, everybody's 0-0 when you go into conference. And for us to get our first victory in conference, it's a statement. And then now we just have to keep going forward.
We came right here today for the fans, not just for us, for the people that pay for the tickets, everybody that's a real diehard Rebel fan. We did it for y'all.
So that first offensive series really set the tone. You got the defense on the heels. You forced a timeout because they were a little bit rattled. Go in for the touchdown. Take us through the mindset of deciding to start the game that way.
We talked about it, you know, and we saw in some of the films there were times where they had a tough time subbing and getting lined up when people weren't fast. And it's something we have in our arsenal. We don't use it a lot, but, you know, we made the decision early in the week we wanted to come out that first series and just kind of go NASCAR. So we did, and, you know, forced them to call a timeout, kind of got everybody energetic and going, and, you know, ended up resulting in a nice first drive touchdown.
We've seen Armani Rodgers grow week to week to week, and it's allowed you guys to open the playbook up a little bit more because he's making good decisions. How are you thinking about how he is progressing as a quarterback?
I tell you what, we're excited about him. We really are. I mean, he's done so many good things early on in this season. And then to come out in a game like this and, you know, to go 7-for-7, you know, run 2 touchdowns, get us into the right plays, manage the no huddle. It was tremendous. I mean, he almost had a perfect half.
We want to get to that blocked punt by Johnny Stanton on special teams. Take us through how that happened to where he comes to you and says, I want to do it.
Yeah, after week two, you know, actually it was after week one, after that first game, you know, that tough game, you know, he came to me and said, hey, coach, you know, it's my senior year, you know, I just want to contribute, I want to help this team however we can, because I know I can do some things. And so we talked about it in the meeting and said, let's put him on some special teams and get him going. And so we've put him on a lot. He's been a two on a lot of them. And this week we decided, let's let him go get a punt. And tremendous. I mean, just the emotion, the energy he brought to it. And then just looking at a guy totally selfless, all team, all UNLV. We love him, man. He's a great guy.
And if you saw the emotion on the sideline and everybody was fired up and chest bump, coaches, players, you name it. That's important to this team growing as you move through the season. A play like that is really important as this team moves forward.
It is, and you can see how much we love each other and how much we care about each other. And, you know, we all love Johnny, and he's a great kid, and he's been a great ambassador for our university. And, you know, tough spot, you know, great kid, and he's got a, you know, young guy in front of him who's doing a great job. But, you know, he found a way to contribute. He found a way to help us make us better. And I'll tell you what, when you have a bunch of guys that are that selfless, you know, it says a lot about what you're building.
The offense obviously gets a lot of attention, but the defense has stepped up here, and especially in the goal line situation, where in the last 2 weeks they're forcing fumbles left and right. I mean, that's such a big swing type play when you can get a turnover inside the five.
It really is. I mean, we have three turnovers inside the 5-yard line in the last 2 weeks, and it's just, you've got that no quit spirit about him, you know. And we give up a ton of yards, you know, chunks of yards, and it got frustrating at times watching him, you know, convert third downs. But I tell you what, we played great red zone defense last night. I mean, we held him to a bunch of field goals, one, you know, touchdown that we can't give up before the half, but 13 points, and then, you know, we just, you know, shut him down completely in the second half. Fourth down stops, turnovers inside the red zone. They're playing hard.
It was fun to watch, certainly. We're just getting started here in the Reb Zone. Up next, we're going to take a closer look at this Saturday's showdown with San Diego State. What are the keys and what Aztec head coach Rocky Long is worried about? That's on the backside of the break as the Reb Zone rolls on.
You're watching the Fox 5 Reb Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie. Your home, your way.
The Rebels have a big showdown this Saturday as Mountain West favorite San Diego State rolls into town. The Aztecs bring with them a lot of momentum, a national ranking, and a running back that fuels everything.
Here
Saturday night at 7:45 at Sam Boyd Stadium. San Diego State rolls in with an undefeated record and national buzz of having the inside track to not only win the Mountain West title, but get to a New Year's Six bowl game. UNLV hopes to spoil the party and make a statement of its own. When you think San Diego State, you think talented, game-breaking running backs. Las Vegas native Donnell Pumphrey is gone, but Rashad Penny has replaced that void quite nicely. Penny got lots of touches even when Pumphrey was there, and he did a lot of damage. But now it's his show, and he says he'll do anything they want him to in order to win.
If they feel like I got to catch the ball, I got to catch the ball. Run the ball 30 times, run the ball 30 times. Catch kickoff return, I got to do it. It really ain't up to me. I mean, I know I'm excited for it. The chances I get, I got to take advantage of it. And this is something that I've been waiting for, so I'm finally getting that chance now. So I just got to go out there and prove it.
Penny is among the nation's leaders in rushing and scoring. Obviously, the Rebels containing him is the key. But getting up in this game and putting the Aztec offense in third and long situations is also crucial to make them try to beat you in the air with quarterback Christian Chapman. The Achilles heel of the SDSU offense has been pass protection, where the line has a sack rate of about 15%. That means the Rebel offense has to put up some points, and that's an area of concern for Aztec head coach Rocky Long.
I think they have a lot of talent, a lot of skills on offense, which we don't like to get into scoring battles. You know, that's why we run what we do. We try to keep the ball away from the other team, but obviously they're quite a challenge.
While the Aztec offense gets a lot of attention, the San Diego State defense is nothing to sneeze at either. SDSU is allowing under 300 yards in total offense a game. Bottom line, this is a huge opportunity for UNLV, a nationally televised game on ESPN2 with a nationally ranked team that just happens to be a rival. The winner of this game puts themselves in position to win the West Division.
Let's start with Rashad Penny. The key word we use in there is contain. It's really hard to stop him completely because he contributes in a lot of different facets of the game. But if you can contain him and limit him, it really changes the complexion of this game.
It does. I mean, you're not just talking about one of the best backs in the Mountain West. You're talking about one of the best backs in the entire nation. He's going to be a great Sunday guy. He's already proven to be a great Saturday guy. So, you know, you need to limit the big plays with him. You know, I mean, he's going to get some yards. We've got to do a great job of swarming to the football, making them go to their second and third options on their offense. You can't just let him carry the ball, like he said, 30 times and rack up 200 yards, which he's done so many times. You know, you got to make sure that you know he's earning everything that he gets, and you're swarming him.
For fans who may be key on some of the skill players, the key to this game might be in the trenches, especially when UNLV is on defense. That's going to be the battle that might determine this thing.
It really is. I mean, that like Rocky said, that's what they've built. They're a big physical team. They're going to run the football, keep the ball away from you, and they're going to play great defense. And that's kind of been his recipe to success. So we've got to do a really good job up front, you know, again, making them put the ball in the air. You know, they don't want to throw the ball 20 times a game. You know, they're comfortable throwing it 8, 9, 10, 11 times. And, you know, that's where they're kind of in their greatest comfort zone. So if we can make them, you know, again, get them in the third down, make them put the ball in the air. If you start seeing them throw the ball more often on first downs, that's a good sign. Now, in order to do that, you're going to have to play great run defense.
It's going to be fun to watch. 7:45 kickoff out at Sam Boyd Stadium. Up next, we're going to get to know Rebel offensive lineman Kyle Saxelid, what he's done at UNLV, what he plans to do in the future, and his love affair with In-N-Out Burger. The Reb Zone, going animal style, just 2 minutes away. Stick and stay.
You're watching the Fox 5 Reb Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie, your home, your way.
It is not often that offensive linemen get put in the spotlight, but it would be a travesty if the fans out there didn't get a chance to meet Kyle Saxelid, one of our favorite Rebels who keeps us laughing constantly. And oh yeah, he's actually really, really good with a chance to play on Sundays. We chatted about three of his favorite things: football, future, and food.
He's a talented football player who was smart and incredibly funny. You may not pay close attention to him during games, but senior Kyle Saxelid is a critical part to making the offense work every play. The left tackle is part of the Orcas, the nickname of the offensive line that doesn't get enough credit for opening rushing lanes or keeping quarterback Armani Rogers upright, and that's okay with Saxelid.
We make things happen down in there. The run game, we open holes up for those magnificent 60-yard touchdowns. You know, we take pride in that. We don't need to be praised by all the outside or anything. We know that when we do a good job, we do a good job, and we hold ourselves accountable when we don't.
This is not a group of big oafy linemen. In fact, it's a very articulate and bright bunch.
I would say that we're probably one of the smartest position groups on the football team. Other than, you know, those quarterback smart guys right there, you know. But, you know, we have a lot on our plate. We got to know a lot of plays. We got to know the assignment for five different positions all in the same play against multiple defensive fronts. You know, we are probably one of the smartest positions on the team.
Saxelid is a perfect example. He's already received his bachelor's degree in business management and is working on his master's right now. The goal is to end up with multiple master's degrees and ultimately own a small business or two. At 6'7 and nearly 300 pounds, his size is imposing, but that's taken a lot of work. Saxelid has added about 50 pounds of muscle to his frame.
I wasn't the strongest person coming in here. I was a very big-time developmental kid. Everybody knew that, and I think I finally reached the point. It only took like 4.5 years. I finally reached the point where I'm able to play productively.
That growth came with a lot of eating, one of Saxelid's favorite pastimes.
I still eat a lot of food, and the key difference now is instead of just stuffing my face with whatever I see, it's that I'm eating good food.
Do you ever sneak out for a double-double
yes.
at In-N-Out?
Yes, I do. You're allowed to sneak out.
I should have made that double-double comment plural, because when the big man is on a cheat day, he goes for it.
Three double-doubles, three fries, vanilla shake, and a soda. That's what you got.
Have you ever done like a 4x4 or anything?
Oh, yeah, but you know, here's the thing. You get more calories from going to double doubles than a 4x4, because you get all the extra, you get the extra buns, you get the extra toppings and everything. 4x4, you just get four patties. I'll get four patties with two double doubles, but I'll end up getting more calories. You got to play the system.
Saxelid says he isn't a huge trash talker in the trenches, but that doesn't mean he doesn't talk to the opponent.
I have conversations with him sometimes, and most of the time it's about food.
Like one game at Colorado State when he confronted a Ram defensive lineman.
Dude, what's that smell? And I like come up to him, and he looks at me and goes, "Those are the funnel cakes." I'm like, "What?" He goes, "Yeah, dude."
He keeps it light, but when it's time to play, Saxelid delivers, which has him poised for a chance to play at the next level.
NFL is a definite possibility. I've been told by multiple people it's definitely a possibility. And if that possibility brings itself forward, then you can't pass that up. And that's something I will definitely shoot for. In the meantime, like I said before, I'm focused on the now. And the most important thing right now is just next up is food, class, practice tomorrow, game this Saturday.
Kyle Saxelid came to UNLV as a tall, goofy kid from Elk Grove, California, with a love for video games and football. He'll leave a well-rounded man with 2 degrees, a blueprint for success, and extreme gratitude for his time in Las Vegas as a Rebel.
It's been an amazing experience. I feel like I've definitely matured. I've made some lifelong friends. I've met some amazing people. I've done some amazing things, I think. I wouldn't trade it for the world.
All right, so he's classic. We've shown that here. He also performs on the field. Sundays, can he play in the NFL?
Well, I'll tell you what, he's got a big, long frame, and like he said, you know, he came in as a developmental guy and done a really good job of changing his body. He's a great competitor, and he's a real intelligent kid, as you saw in that piece. So he's got a shot. You know, I mean, there's definitely some intangibles there that people really like about him, and he keeps being productive. He'll get an opportunity.
If not, spokesman for In-N-Out, I think, is in his future.
I'll tell you what, that's the first time I saw the piece. That was pretty funny. So yeah, I didn't realize he was such a comedian, but that's good to see.
We're going to take a double-double right now, a two-minute break, but before we come back with the Rebel Players of the Week, we're going to give you the scores from the Mountain West teams over the weekend.
You're watching the Fox 5 Reb Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie, your home, your way.
Big week, big game, big opportunity on the plate for the Rebels.
Absolutely. I mean, that's what you worked for, you know, whole offseason, getting the conference. You go 1-0. Now you got your defending conference champs coming in, top 25 team. Should be a heck of a night out at Sam Boyd. Hopefully we can pack the house, get everybody out there, and play a great game.
We are looking forward to it. 7:45 is the kickoff out at Sam Boyd. We hope you go out there and pack the house here for the game against the big rivals, and a very important game for UNLV to maybe put themselves in contention for not only a bowl game, but maybe the Mountain West Championship. Strange to be talking about that, but this team is good enough to line up with San Diego State, so it's going to be a good one out of Sam Boyd. That is it for us for this edition of the Reb Zone. We leave you with the Rebel football plays of the week. We'll see you next Sunday. Good night. We didn't listen when they said it can't be done. We're on a mission to prove everybody wrong. We had a vision, now we've risen above everyone. We didn't listen when they said it can't be done. It's gonna make the papers, it's gonna hit the news. Cause fear don't haunt the man that's got nothing left to lose. 100 years from now, they'll still be talking, girl. Always remembering the day we rocked the world.
Zone Sports Show was presented by RC Willie. Your home, your way.